Hi, this is Renee Stanley from Movie Review Relay. And yeah, did you get to fill out the Academy Awards this week? I did. It was nice. It was fine. It was nothing wrong. Everybody's, the world's still turning, right? Everything worked out. It's okay. But we'll talk about it a little bit, and then we'll move on to the movies of the week. We have to watch these movies every week, guys. We have to stay focused with the movies.
Relay.
And we're talking about the Academy Awards. Did you see it? Yeah, everybody saw it, even the people that didn't want to see it because it was all over the news. La La Land was going to sweep all of the nominations, especially the big one, like Best Picture. So here we are at the end of the ceremony, and they announced La La Land. No, as you know, Moonlight won. But here's the interesting part. Ageism has to stop. Warren Beatty saw that it was the wrong name. You can see the way he hesitated. But he didn't even trust himself to go to the producer or the stage manager and say, excuse me, this doesn't have Best Picture, it has Best Supporting Actress on it, it's the wrong envelope. I think he felt that people might say he was old, senile, which some of them did. If you looked on Twitter, if you were tweeting live, you saw that people were very brutal, calling him old man, old senile stuff, just terrible stuff you should never do. So he gives the envelope to Faye Dunaway, and I don't think he gave Faye Dunaway the envelope for her to introduce. I think he just gave it to her to inspect it and to say that, see, it doesn't say Best Picture. But instead, she goes ahead, she's winging it, and I think she's doing this because, again, these are old veteran, I shouldn't say that. Okay, so these are veteran actors and actresses. Some of them have produced themselves. They know the show must go on, it's a live show. So I think that's the reason why she said La La Land, because she just saw La La Land on there, and she didn't want to rock the boat, which she should have. The boat should have been rocked when Warren got it. All right, but for whatever reason, he didn't want to do it. He didn't want to say it, whatever it was. So of course, the La La Land producer was into his speech, having had a couple other speeches, I think, before him. But anyway, he wasn't having it, okay? When the stage producer started scurrying around him, when the producers, the stage managers, start to come behind everybody and try to correct the problem, it was very interesting that Jordan Horowitz, which I understand is the producer. Anyway, he's associated with La La Land. When Jordan Horowitz got the winning envelope, he wasn't having it. He decided to go ahead and announce it himself. He didn't even wait until Warren Beatty could gather his thoughts together and everything. And he went ahead and announced it and held, as you know, the sign up that said Moonlight Best Picture. So that everybody knew it wasn't one of Jimmy Kimmel's practical jokes, which Jimmy Kimmel does a lot. If you've ever been to his studio or anything like that, because they even played one on me one time. I'll tell you about it another time. But anyway, he wasn't having it. He snatched the envelope from Warren and went ahead and told everybody it was Moonlight. And I'm not joking. You really won. You beat us. You know, we lost or whatever it was. Okay, so the world is still turning, right? The person who worked for the accounting office was responsible since he gave out the wrong envelope. Warren Beatty, because of ageism again, kept the wrong envelope. He wouldn't give it up. When they said, could we have the envelope back, the wrong one, sir? And Warren was like, no. Because he wanted everyone to know that it wasn't his fault. He felt that he had to do that. And he felt that way because we're in such a youth-oriented society. Yeah, we know you're always talking about us because we were older, me and Faye. All right, so he straightened it out. I understand that Moonlight is just elated, which they should be. It's quite an honor, you know? And the Academy Awards were fun. Did you like Jimmy Kimmel? Some people loved him, some people hated him. I thought he was fine, you know? They found out that some of the people that they invited in on a tour, if anybody saw that part, yeah, one of those guys was in jail or ex-convict or whatever. I don't know. That's the chance you take, right? When you just invite people off the street like that. Yeah, because everybody's walking on the street with amongst us. So it's one of these things that happened. I don't know. So I'll put on a roll at the end of the video who won. Because, we were glad that that was the big one, Moonlight. We were glad to see Viola. Viola won Best Supporting Actress for her role in Fences. Now, Viola, we love that because she had a husband there and they were so wonderful together. If you saw them together on interviews, she had him by her side. He didn't try to steal her light. And she was just happy to be a family woman and to be acknowledged at this point as a woman of color, a beautiful woman of color that she is. Beautiful woman, period. Okay, I've said that before on How to Get Away with Murder. Those who watch the ABC series. Yeah. How to Get Away, ABC is what they call it. But you know what it is. It's her series that she's in. So she's very pretty, and I'm so happy for her. She deserves it. She's been acting a long time, you know. So she did good. So we're happy for Viola. All right. And Emma Stone. Yeah, she started as a young woman. She came to California or to Hollywood with nothing, basically. And she worked her way up the ranks. She's been in a lot of movies. If you know Emma Stone, then you like her work, you know. It's like everybody else had a hits and misses, but she looks so beautiful in this gold gown. I'll leave the picture below or either link it. It was a wonderful night for her. Good for her. I'm happy for her. And Ben Affleck's brother, Casey, won Best Actor. Casey Affleck was fine. There were other actors that were good too. Everyone's good, so you can't really complain when he wins something. He's another guy who's been, you know, working his way through the ranks. He didn't want anybody, I'm sure, to feel like he's riding on his brother's coattails. He has his own talent, his own unique talent, his own unique style. So we were happy for him too. And Mahershala Ali, to put his handsome self, won the Best Supporting Actor Award, and we're very happy for him. He was in Hidden Figures, all right? And then he played this part, which was complete opposite of the part he played. So he has a lot of range, okay? Between the two movies, he's played completely polar opposite roles. So this is a man who's very talented, very handsome. Good for him, right? And he said he just had a baby too. A double blessing. All right, so then Damien Chazelle won Best Director for La La Land. And yeah, he deserved that. Yeah, did you see the film? A lot of singing, a lot of dramatic stuff. I tell everyone, it reminds me, because I'm older, yeah, I said that. of Ginger Rogers and Fred Astaire type musical at one point, it touched on that. So it appealed to several demographics. It appealed to the older demographics, and he had all these young people in it, so that drew in a younger crowd. It gained speed slowly. It wasn't a blockbuster right away. People have seen it over time, word of mouth. And it reminded me also of Glee, you know, a lot of these modern day musicals that we have out now. Very nicely done. Very nicely done. I said that when it first came out. If you look back on some of my old videos, I mentioned it. All right. Suicide Squad won for makeup. And I'm mentioning it again because I hear that, yeah, they're going to have a sequel, which you kind of knew they were setting it up for the sequel when you saw the first one. That's fine. So look forward to that. Mel Gibson's action film Hacksaw Ridge won Best Editing and Best Sound Design. So people are having a hard time forgiving Mel. But I say forgive him and let's move on. You know, I know what he said. I understand. I know what he said. But yeah, it's all right. I don't know why. I just feel like we should forgive. All right, here we go. But I have to say, this young man who messed up in the accounting department, I understand. They say he's a Matt Damon lookalike. Ooh, you know, everybody. This young man probably got caught up in the... Well, he's 57. Is that young? Middle age. Well, whatever. He probably got caught up in the moment. They said he was taking pictures of Emma Stone prior to this event going on, to this mistake being made. And they said it was his mistake. He gave Warren Beatty the wrong envelope. Fine. But in the day we're living at, everybody's on the cell phone doing social media. I can't go into the store. It could be a office, a municipal office. Yeah, you got all kind of people under the desk. Sometimes even in front of you, sometimes it's a supervisor, they're on their cell phone, doing social network stuff. So I don't know if it is his fault and he shouldn't have been doing it, but no, it's not the worst thing that happened in the world. So we're just gonna move on, right? Forgive this guy, whoever he is, you know, God bless him. I hope he has peace, because I know he's getting ribbed, because on Twitter, they just, you know, put him through. They call him names and all this kind of stuff once they found out what happened. Well, what are you gonna do? All right, so I'll leave the link of the other winners, because there are other things that happened. Other people won awards that night. The show opened with this beautiful, beautiful rendition. Justin Timberlake opened the ceremony with this beautiful number that he does for the movie, Trolls. A lot of energy. Dance all up and down the aisles with his dancers. He was great. Justin is very talented, you know that, all right. So, once that happened, Jimmy took over, Jimmy Kimmel. He was the host. You can judge how good he did. Some people said he did good, some people said he did bad. Some people said the only thing that saved the show from being extremely boring is the last thing that happened, which, as you know, was mixed up with the envelopes. All right, so until we meet again, it's Renee Stanley for our movie review relay. God bless.